driving a Formula One car at over 200 miles per hour. Still not be enough to get your heart racing? Then you've come to the right place. Because it's time for World Championship Sloth Racing! Not what you were expecting? Don't let their appearance fool you. When these sloths get on the racetrack, look out! You're in for the most intense 2 feet of racing you've ever seen. Let's meet our four competitors. First up is Larry McLightning. Now, everyone who thinks Larry is gonna win, stand up and shout as loud as you can. Next up we have Susie Swift. Everyone who thinks Susie is gonna win, stand up and shout as loud as you can. In the third starting spot is Bob Boomerang. If you think Bob is gonna win, stand up and shout as loud as you can. In our final spot is Frankie Too Fast. If you think Frankie is gonna win, stand up and shout as loud as you can. All right, our sloths are ready to race. Don't forget to cheer as loud as you can for your sloth. We're gonna start in 3, 2, 1, and they're off. Frankie is battling for position. They're giving it all they've got today.
Oh, I'm afraid to blink.
It's total chaos.
Oh, Larry makes a move.
Look out.
Oh, my.
Oh, no.
This is a record-setting pace.
Susie almost wiped out.
The speed is unreal.
They're neck and neck.
Oh, it's definitely too close to call.
What a great move. What is Bob thinking?
It's definitely too close to call.
Frankie is battling for position.
They're giving it all they've got today.
Whoa, I'm afraid to blink. It's total chaos. Larry makes a move. Look out.
Oh, my.
Oh, no.
This is a record-setting pace.
Susie almost wiped out. The speed is unreal. They're neck and neck. It's definitely too close to call.
What a great move.
What is Bob thinking?
Oh, it's definitely too close to call.
Oh, Larry makes a move. Look out. Wow. Larry McLightning wins a photo finish. Congrats to all you Larry fans out there. I don't know about you folks, but I was on the edge of my seat that entire race. Be sure to join us next time for more Sloth Racing Action.
talked about how God comforts us. And we haven't had a chance to sing this song a lot this week, but I know you like this one, so let's go ahead and sing this.
There have been times my heart was sad.
You may be seated. We're going to move real quickly through our opening today. So let's talk about real quick all of our Bible points. On day one, we learned that God knows us. Awesome. On day two, we learned that God hears us. On day three, we learned that God comforts us. You are treasured. Last night, we learned that God forgives us. And today we're learning that God chooses us. You are treasured. Awesome. And our Bible verse for today, look at the screen. Put your hands on your mouth. It says, I have called you by name. But then I want you to, okay, go ahead. I have called you by name. And then when it says, you are mine, I want you to point to someone else. I'm the you. And then I want you to point up to him, okay? So, I have called you by name. You are mine. Do it again. I have called you by name. You are mine. And that's found in Isaiah 43:1. Awesome. Our last buddy, I think you all know who it is. Point to our last buddy of the week. Raymond, check it out. Raymond
the
Cayman.
Are you ready for the rest of the quest? Welcome back to another day of adventure. Meet Raymond. You probably think you know what animal he is, but everyone gets this wrong. Alligator? Crocodile? Nope. Raymond is a caiman, kin to those bigger guys. You might say he's greater than a gator with crocodile style. Here's a quick family tree. Raymond's family is called crocodilians. In that family, there are alligators, crocodiles, and gharials. Sort of like the way you have aunts, uncles, cousins, second cousins, you get the idea. Of course, there are different kinds of crocodiles, alligators, and gharials. And he's right there, under the alligator branch. Got it? One way to tell them apart is by where they live. Caimans like the warm, tropical water found in rivers or swamps in Central and South America. Raymond prefers his water fresh, but some of his caiman cousins like salt water. Usually, they're pretty quiet. After all, he can't be too noisy or he'd scare away his dinner. But sometimes, Raymond needs to give a shout out to his buddies. Raymond's lungs fill up so much that the water on his back vibrates. We're not saying he's lazy, but he does spend most of his day just basking in the sun. Oh, time for another nap. Out here, there aren't many animals that hunt caimans, so Raymond doesn't even have to keep an eye out to stay safe. Of course, it's always good to keep watch when these guys are sneaking around. Speaking of sneaking, Raymond can be pretty sneaky too. God put Raymond's eyes and nose on the top of his head. That way he can slowly swim through the water and sneak up on a snack. Yum! And when Raymond decides to take a bite, it's a big bite. God gave these reptiles plenty of sharp teeth and some of the strongest jaws on the planet. Grabbing lunch is a snap. Raymond needs all the tricks and help he can get to catch food. On land, his legs are pretty short. Let's just say he won't be winning any prizes for running. But water is another thing. Caimans have such strong tails that they don't even need to use their legs. Ah, nothing like a nice, slow swim. God gave Raymond all kinds of ways to blend in and camouflage, so he stays safe and eats the food he needs to grow. For Raymond, the caiman, blending in and going unnoticed is a good thing. But for people, I think it's kind of different. Most of the time, you don't like just blending into the crowd. You like it when people see you and choose you for something. It feels good when someone knows your name and wants you for a friend. Well, I have golden news for you. God chooses you. You're a treasure. In the Bible, God has this message for his family. I have called you by name. You are mine. To God, you don't blend into the crowd. You're special, amazing, unique, awesome. God has important plans just for you. God chooses you. You are treasure.
Awesome. Great.
Welcome back to KidVid Cinema. I cannot believe it is our last day together. I've had so much fun watching amazing stories and learning about how God treasures us. Which video was your favorite? My favorite was John's. Learning that God hears us even when we don't speak out loud is so amazing. Well, after maybe today's video, you might have a new favorite. Are you ready? I can't wait to see who we'll meet today.
Hi, I'm Genevieve, and I'm 11 years old. I live with my mom, my dad, my sister, and my cousin in Orange County, California.
Genevieve likes spending time with her family. She likes to play with her sister. Her family watches movies together, swims, and goes on walks. Genevieve also does ballet. But what she really loves is swimming. Genevieve and her sister started swimming lessons when she was around 8 years old. One day, her instructors chose her to be part of a swimming club where she would race other swimmers. At first, Genevieve didn't feel very strong about her swimming. But one day, something amazing happened.
I remember one time that I was doing swimming. It was a normal practice. And at this time, I was probably one of the slowest people in my group. And then I was just swimming. And then all of a sudden, I felt this holy power that I could go faster. And I passed every single person in my lane. And I ended up being the fastest person from that day on.
Being chosen means Genevieve is part of a team. That team is a lot like a family. The coaches wanted Genevieve to be part of their team because they knew she could do great things. Being chosen for the swim team means Genevieve must train hard. She practices 5 days a week for 2.5 hours each day. Genevieve relies on her coaches and trainers to help her become a better, faster swimmer. She also relies on God, too.
I normally rely on God to help me with my races. Like, I normally get kind of scared before a race, so I ask Him to help me, like, become kind of more confident with myself and that He will love me no matter what I get.
Genevieve hopes to be able to go to the Olympics and win a gold medal in swimming. She'll have to work hard every day for many more years to be chosen for that team. Genevieve knows that she's already been chosen as part of God's family, and she didn't have to work for that at all. God chose her just because He loves her. Did you know that you've been chosen to be part of God's family too? In the Bible, the book of Isaiah says, "I have called you by name. You are mine." That's right. God chooses you and He calls you His very own. You don't have to work or earn God's love. He picks you as His friend just because. God made you for a purpose. You can ask God to show you what He has chosen you to do. God will help you do amazing things. God chooses you. You are treasured.
Wow, Genevieve has to work really hard and hope to be chosen for the Olympics. What's something you'd like to be chosen for? Was it something that you had to work really hard for? I had to work hard to be chosen for my school's basketball team. Sometimes we might not get to be chosen for the things we want to do, but we have to remember that God chooses you. You are treasured. You don't have to work hard to be chosen by God. God loves you just for being you. Today's verse comes from Isaiah 43:1. "I have called you by name, you are mine." All week we have discovered that God treasures us, and today we are learning that God chooses us. You are treasured. I don't know about you, but that makes me feel very special. I love that this verse says that Jesus calls us by name and He knows who we are. Today, we got to see how God chose Genevieve. Let's think back on all the other cool things we have learned from our videos this week. On the first day of Kidbid Cinema, we met Sam. Sam knows a lot about Rubik's Cubes. Watching Sam, we learned that God knows you. You are treasured. After Sam, we met John, who got to learn how to talk to God and others using sign language. From John, we learned that God hears you. You are treasured. After John, we met a whole bunch of kids who helped show God's comfort during the pandemic. They helped us learn that God comforts you. You are treasured. Yesterday, we met Philip and Timothy. Those brothers got into a big fight, but then experienced God's forgiveness. Philip and Timothy's story helps us remember that God forgives you. You are treasure. Today, we learned about Genevieve, who really hopes to be chosen for the Olympics one day. And we learned that God chooses you. You are treasure. We have a final Bible buddy to add to our collection. Raymond the Cayman helps us remember that God will always choose us. Raymond has the Bible verse on the bottom, so you will always remember that God calls you by name. Now you'll have a whole set of buddies to remind you of kids camp and of the Bible points we have learned throughout the week. I'm so glad that we had an awesome week this week, and I'm so sad it's almost over. Let's pray and give thanks for a great week. Dear Lord, thank you for treasuring us and for always choosing us. Thank you for loving us and forgiving us. Please help us to never forget that. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you so much for joining me for KidVid Cinema. Have a great summer. Bye.
To Imagination Station. It's hard to believe this is our last day. Today, we're discovering that God chooses you. You are treasured. But before we dig into that, I get to ask you one last time. Did you bring your imagination today? Today, we're going to need loads and loads of imagination. I was just talking to my friend Raymond, the caiman, and you won't believe what he told me. Did you know a caiman can run up to 30 miles per hour? That's as fast as a car. Whoa, amazing. Hop up. Let's pretend you're in a race with Raymond. Let's see how fast you can run in place, right where you're at. Run as fast as you can in place. You kids are crazy fast, but I'm not sure that you could beat Raymond in a race. That fellow is fast. Now that your imaginations are moving, let's find out today's question. Do you think caimans sense vibrations in the water from prey with their jaws or with their claws? Okay, time for the drum roll so I can reveal the amazing answer. And the answer is their jaws. They have bundles of nerve fibers only in their jaws, which help them sense vibrations made by nearby prey. Imagine that. Before we have fun with our last sciencey fun gizmo, let's do some exploring. We've met our friend Raymond the caiman. One thing I notice about him is that he blends right in with the plants and trees and grass. That's called camouflage. When an animal is camouflaged, that means God designed it to blend in with its habitat and protect it. I have a challenge for you now. I'll put some images on screen. See if you can see an animal hiding in the picture. Did you spot this guy? Nope. No one hiding here. Who's hiding here? Did you see this friend? No critters here. Wow, this guy really blends in. It's amazing how well critters can hide when they're camouflaged. Let's see if you can camouflage a furry friend at home. Go find a small stuffed animal and hide it in a place where it's visible, but it blends in. This is my friend, the camel. I'm gonna put him right over here. Under some tan ferns. He is camouflaged. Ready? Now you try. God knew some animals needed to blend in for safety. I don't know about you, but sometimes I feel like I blend into the background too, almost like nobody sees me. Have you ever felt like that? The good news is God always sees you and me. We don't blend into the background. God knows you. He even knows every hair on your head. He has a special plan for you, and He loves you. God chooses you. You are treasured. Now, it's time to discover our sciencey fun gizmo. It's called a Rolling Raymond, in honor of our friend, Raymond the Cayman. You can choose which way to roll Raymond the Cayman by tipping a tray or a plate. The little marble inside makes him roll along whichever way you choose. Follow along with me to make your own Raymond the Cayman, step by step. First, you'll color the printed side of the cardboard piece. Next, with the printed side out, slightly fold the crease on Raymond's back and snout. Now, hold the underside, where Raymond's belly is, in a place so the straight edge is square with the slits at his neck. Tape it in place at the armpit and base of tail. Ready? Gently bend up the neck and bend the tail at the fold line so Raymond's body lays flat on a surface. Fold his feet down just slightly at the fold lines. Finally, gently press a marble into the hole in Raymond's belly. Set rolling Raymond on a plate or tray and tip it to move him around. You even got a Try This at Home sticker to remind you of the way Raymond connects with God's Word. Put that sticker on a Ziploc bag and give Raymond a safe place to stay. Thanks for joining me at Imagination Station this week.
Welcome back to Bible Adventures. Today, we're going to explore another totally true adventure straight from the Bible. Today's true story from the Bible has a pretty complicated plot, so we won't have time to go into all the details, but you can read the whole exciting adventure in your Bible at home later today. It's all in the book of Esther. As this book of the Bible opens, Esther is in an incredible position. Let me quickly give you a little background. The king of Persia had decided to find a new queen. He sent agents into every part of the kingdom to find young women and bring them to the palace. The women would get beauty treatments for a year, and then the king would choose a new queen. This is where Esther comes in. I know, this sounds kind of like a fairy tale, doesn't it? Cinderella or something like that, but it really happened. Hey, maybe that's where Disney got the idea. Anyway, a man named Mordecai lived right near the palace, and his cousin named Esther lived with his family. When her parents died, Mordecai had adopted Esther. All of them were Jews who had been forced out of Jerusalem. So Esther was taken to the king's palace with a bunch of other women. Each young woman got the beauty treatments for 12 months. Well, after a year, the king set the royal crown on Esther's head and chose her as the queen.
Oh my, I didn't expect anyone to be here. Excuse me, but who are you and how did you get into the royal palace?
Hi, Esther. We were just talking about you.
Oh, really? But who are you? Are you friends? Oh, I hope you're friends. I could really use some friends right now.
Yes, Esther, we're your friends. We believe in the one true God, just like you do.
Shh, not so loud. Shh. Yes, it's true. I am a Jew and I do believe in God, but well, my cousin Mordecai advised me not to tell anyone at the palace that I'm a Jew, and Mordecai's always helped me, so I did what he said.
You know, friends, Esther has Mordecai and her family to help her do the right thing. Right now, say the name of a family member who helps you do the right thing.
I'm so glad you have family members who will help you out. And I'm so glad you're my new friends. Will you help me out?
What's going on?
I'm in a real spot. There's this awful man, Haman. He's a powerful advisor to the king, and well, Haman decided that everyone in the kingdom should bow down when he passed by, but Mordecai refused. Of course, Mordecai would only bow before God, not silly old Haman.
That makes sense.
But that made Haman really mad. Haman knows that Mordecai is a Jew, so Haman told the king that there's this troublesome group of people who won't follow the king's rules. He meant the Jews, of course. So he convinced the king to kill all the Jews.
That's horrible.
I know, and now Mordecai says I need to go before the king and beg for my people's lives. But the king doesn't even know I'm a Jew. And what's worse, everyone knows that if I go before the king without being invited, he, well, I can't even say it. He could have me killed. Anyone who appears before the king without being invited is doomed to die, unless the king holds out his scepter. That's this big, shiny stick thing, and what are the chances of that? If I go before the king, I'm probably going to die.
Esther, what are you gonna do? Are you willing to die?
Well, it's not on my list of favorite things to do today, but Mordecai sent me a message that's helping me. He said, don't think for a moment that because you're in the palace, you'll escape when all the other Jews are killed. Who knows if perhaps you were made queen for just such a time as this?
Wow! It sounds like God chose you to be queen just for this reason. But what are you gonna do?
I asked Mordecai to tell all the Jews to fast for me, not to eat or drink for 3 days. My maids and I would do the same. We'd all turn to God and ask for his help. Then, after 3 days, I'd go before the king. Today is day 3. The time has come. My new friends, will you help me?
Friends, what do you think? Can we help Esther?
If the king doesn't kill me right away when I go before him, and that's a big if, I'm going to ask the king and Haman to come to a banquet that I prepare. At the banquet, I'll let the king know of Haman's plot, and I'll tell the king that I'm a Jew.
Well, how can we help?
Well, just in case it all goes well, you could help prepare the banquet. Just grab a snack wherever you are, some fruit snacks, crackers, or a bit of cereal. My servants here will be getting a feast ready, so you can join in. Throne room. Oh no, what am I going to do? I can't do this. Why did God choose me for this? Okay, I'm going in now.
Esther, God chose you for this job. He'll help you, and we can help you too. Let's call out some encouragement to Esther. Call out some encouragement to Esther right where you are. I know you can do it. God is with you. I know something that's true for all of you. God has chosen you to be his friend. He said this through the prophet Isaiah, "I have called you by name. You are mine." And later, God inspired the Apostle Paul to write, "So now we can rejoice in our wonderful new relationship with God, because our Lord Jesus Christ had made us friends of God." Just like God chose Esther, God chooses you. You are treasured.
My friends, thank you for helping me stand strong. The king didn't kill me. Well, I guess that's obvious, but look, I'm alive. Maybe God did choose me to be queen so I could help my people. God chose me, And I just know that God has chosen each of you for something amazing too. Anyway, I have to hurry now and dress for the banquet. Thank you again for being such treasured friends.
That was so cool, getting to meet Esther, a queen. The Bible tells us the king was furious with Haman and got rid of him. Then he put Mordecai in charge of all Haman's property. But best of all, the Jews were saved. All because one young woman did what God had chosen her to do. I can't wait to see what God has in store for each of you, because you are treasured.
Thank you, Red. Whoa, okay. job, Green. Awesome. That song is one big mouthful, isn't it? Great work. Okay, boys and girls, you can take a seat for just a minute. We'll do some more songs in just a minute, okay? Each night we've had a Bible point that in every station, the children have moved around to 7 stations really in one evening. Open and closing, snack in the middle, and then they rotate to 4 places. So every 20 minutes, the kids move. And all throughout the camp, they've learned one Bible point for each night. So we're just going to roll through them really, really quick. The first night, we learned that God knows us. Good. And we also learned on day 2 that God hears us. Awesome. And we also learned that God comforts us. That's so good. So good you remember. And last night we learned that God forgives us. And tonight we've been talking about how God chooses you. Oh, awesome job. Great job.
Oh, Dr. Diggingstone, I was hoping you'd show up.
I'm heading home today and thought I'd stop by to say goodbye.
You're leaving already?
Yeah, I didn't find the treasure I was looking for. I think maybe you got some bad information about there being buried treasure around here. Say, can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Why have you all been so kind to me? I was mean when we first met, but you weren't mean to me. That doesn't happen with most treasure hunters I know.
Well, we know God loves us, and he loves you too. To God, we're priceless. God chooses you.
You are treasure.
I'm not sure you have that right. I go look for treasure. I'm not treasure. At least, I don't feel like treasure.
God loves us on the good days, on the bad days, and every day.
So you're saying God chooses me? Like, he picked me?
That's right.
That doesn't happen very often either. In fact, the only reason I became a treasure hunter is because I didn't get to play to play soccer in the 3rd grade. And so I went around finding little coins in the ground.
You're so valuable to God, and he chooses you every time.
Well, I want to know more. I want to choose God back.
That's the best decision you'll ever make.
Okay.
My hands,
I will serve you.
job. Great job, yellow. Last crews up are blue. All right.
I am not forgotten. I am not forgotten. I am not forgotten. God knows my name. I am not forgotten. I am not forgotten. I am not forgotten. God knows my name. He knows my name. I am not forgotten. I am not forgotten. I am not forgotten. God knows my name. I am not forgotten. I am not forgotten. I am not forgotten. God knows my name. He knows my name. He knows my name. Light of the darkness. Strength of the weakness.
Great job, Blue. All right, last time with our theme song.
I am a priceless treasure. God knows me, God hears me, God is my comfort. I am His and there's nothing better. Forgiven and chosen forever. I am a treasure. Treasure, God.